Hi guys, welcome to the 12th case recap of the K-drama Extraordinary Attorney Woo. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to it. One morning, Yoon-woo and her father get visited by their landlady and her father Yoon-bak. Yoon-bak has come to meet Yoon-woo to get legal advice. The landlady explains that on their way to Yoon-bak's house, they have to pass a cultural heritage site called Hyun-jisa. As they pass the site, they were stopped and charged just for passing the area of local heritage, despite the fact they have no intentions to visit it. Yoon-bak is furious about it, and is determined to file a lawsuit against it, even though Yoon-woo explains to him that he'd have to pay more than the admission fee for the lawyers as a commission. Yoon-woo gets excited on hearing that Hyun-jisa is on Jeju Island, since dolphins live in the nearby ocean. Myung-seok, on the other hand, goes to get checked up in a hospital after coughing off blood the other night. After Myung-seok gets to the office, Yoon-woo excitingly tells about the case to Myung-seok, and informs him that the client made it clear that he does not care about the cost of the lawsuit. To everyone's surprise, Myung-seok decides they should all go to Jeju to work on the case. During lunch, Joon-ho informs Yoon-woo that he is still upset about Yoon-woo not considering them to be dating. He suggests meeting his sister and brother-in-law when they go to Jeju since they live there. After work, Yoon-woo goes to see Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik and tells them about Joon-ho being upset with her. Yoon-woo wonders what really changes when they officially date. She also informs that she will be meeting Joon-ho's sister and brother-in-law when they go to Jeju Island. On hearing it, Geu-ra-mi advises her on what Yoon-woo should do when meeting her future in-laws, like only saying things they want to hear. On hearing Min-woo is going on the business trip, Geu-ra-mi reasons with Min-sik that they should go on a business trip to Jeju as well, since their only customer Yoon-woo is leaving. On the day of the business trip, Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik also join Yoon-woo and the team. Since they all are going to the same place, Myung-seok suggests that they should hang out together. At Jeju Island, Myung-seok decides to ride with Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik, seeing that they have rented an open-roof car, unlike Joon-ho, who has rented a van for them. Myung-seok enjoys the trip with Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik, while Yoon-woo and others work on the case. Just like they were informed, the group gets stopped on entering the area of the Hyun-jisa's temple. Soo-yeon records as the admission fee collector approach them. When the fee collector argues that it is a lawful collection, Yoon-woo questions if he's going to charge a fee even if they are not visiting the site. The fee collector argues that Hyun-jisa is a huge temple, and he can't follow them to see if they are visiting or not because of its size. The fee collector also adds that even the government is aware and has permitted the ticket booth. He then notices Soo-yeon filming him. When he tries to snatch the camera from Soo-yeon, Min-woo interferes, reasoning that they should be allowed to film the area, since they are in a tourist spot. Before things heat up, Joon-ho agrees to pay the fee. Myung-seok pays on behalf of Min-sik and Geu-ra-mi. He realizes that there is no way out of the ticket booth unless they make an illegal U-turn. Myung-seok convinces the others to go to one of his favorite noodle shops in the area, which is Hanbuk Noodles. But when they get there, they notice it's out of business. Yoon-woo notices that Myung-seok is saddened to see the noodle shop is closed. At the trial, Myung-seok's team plays the video Soo-yeon filmed. They notice the trial is attended by the monks of the Hyun-jisa temple. The defense lawyer displays a map of the Hyun-jisa. As for it, the highway road passes through the property of Hyun-jisa temple. The defense attorney also adds that the highway is built as a tourist road in 1988, so people could conveniently tour the area. After hearing both sides, the judge schedules the trial for another date. After the hearing, the chief monk approaches Myung-seok and the team to ask if they would like to visit Hyun-jisa temple, since they will be giving a special prayer on that day. So the team visits the temple to attend the prayer. After the prayer, the chief monk explains to the team that many trees were cut down to build the road, and wildlife gets killed regularly because of the road. The special prayer is for those deceased souls. Later, on seeing the team working on the case, Myung-seok interferes and decides to hang out instead of always working. Soo-yeon offers to bring drinks for the group, and Min-woo also decides to go with her. Soo-yeon gets annoyed by the sudden change in Min-woo for helping her out, and refuses to go with him, but on Myung-seok's interference, Min-woo ends up going with her. On their way back after buying the drinks, Min-woo decides to check out a nearby bridge. As they walk, Min-woo gets a call from his father, and Soo-yeon notices his change of mood. After the call, Soo-yeon wonders if something is wrong. Min-woo admits that he has a lot going on since he is the breadwinner of the family, unlike Soo-yeon who has everything. That is why he needs to earn more. On hearing it, Soo-yeon gets empathetic towards Min-woo. Myung-seok tells them about how he and his wife came to Jeju on their honeymoon, and she later divorced him because he was too focused on work. They came to Jeju instead of going abroad because he had to be available even during his honeymoon. He gets emotional on remembering the time his wife Ji-soo was upset because all he did was work. The next day, Joon-ho finds Yoon-woo ready to go whale watching. Joon-ho informs her that his sister Soo-mi has arranged a meal and wants to have lunch with them, since they are meeting Yoon-woo for the first time. He also informs her that Soo-mi has not prepared gimbap. When Joon-ho tries to call Soo-mi to tell her that they will not be joining them for lunch, Yoon-woo interrupts and tells him that she wants to have lunch with them. Yoon-woo and Joon-ho then go to the coast to watch dolphins, but to their disappointment, they don't get to see any dolphins. They then go to meet with Soo-mi and her husband. Yoon-woo tries to follow up the instructions Geu-ra-mi gave her, but Soo-mi and others notice that she is forcing herself. After Yoon-woo leaves to use the bathroom, Soo-mi advises Joon-ho that he should be seeing a person that would make him happy, not a person that he should take care of all the time. Yoon-woo overhears their conversation. Soo-mi orders Joon-ho not to tell about Yoon-woo to their parents, since that would cause them a shock. On the next hearing, Myung-seok struggles to hold up his pain. Everyone gets shocked when Myung-seok suddenly collapses on the floor. Myung-seok ends up in the hospital. He assures Seon-young that he is in stage 3 stomach cancer, and would also finish up the Hyun-jisa temple case, and he'll get the surgery done after returning to Seoul. They notice that Myung-seok hasn't eaten much, to which Myung-seok reasons that he doesn't have the appetite. So Yoon-woo suggests getting him a bowl of noodles from his favorite restaurant. Even though it is out of business, Yoon-woo suggests asking the former owner to make some noodles for Myung-seok. But Myung-seok orders them to focus on the Hyun-jisa case without wasting their time. As they leave the hospital, Yoon-woo decides to look for the restaurant owner. So they decide to split up and look for the owner. Yoon-woo goes to the restaurant that is most popular in the area, which is Hyeongun Noodles, and asks its owner for the whereabouts of the Hyeongbuk Noodles owner. Joon-ho notices one of the chefs gets alerted on hearing the question. The owner of the Hyeongun Noodles tells them that the Hyeongbuk Noodles fell off because he couldn't catch up with them. Joon-ho notices the chef leaving the kitchen after listening to the owner badmouthing the closed restaurant. Min-woo and Soo-yeon also go around asking for the owner of the Hyeongbuk Noodles, but the residents tell them that no one knows where he is. Later, Joon-ho waits outside the Hyeongun Noodles to meet the chef. But on seeing him acting suspicious, Joon-ho decides to follow him. Apparently, he has gone to feed a cat at Hyeongbuk Noodles. The chef gets startled at seeing Joon-ho, but decides to confess the truth to him. He explains that he initially worked at Hyeongbuk Noodles. While he was still working there, he was recruited by the Hyeongun Noodles. After recruiting him, Hyeongun Noodles owner has asked him to make the noodle taste exactly like that Hyeongbuk Noodles. Hyeongun has eventually taken over all the customers of Hyeongbuk Noodles, and so Hyeongbuk ran out of business. Joon-ho asks if he knows where Hyeongbuk owner is, so he tells him about Hyeongbuk's owner, once telling him that he would like to relax in a place where the mountain and the water is nice. Joon-ho tells about his findings to others. Yoon-woo assumes that he is in a nursing home with that kind of view. She remembers a letter from the pile of letters at Hyeongbuk restaurant with an address of a nursing home, and assumes that the owner is there. Joon-ho and Yoon-woo go to check on the nursing home. They hand over the letter that was at the restaurant to the receptionist, who quickly remembers the person, and informs them that his mother is staying at the nursing home. Apparently, the Hyeongbuk's owner has been visiting his mother once a month, and has visited the hospital the day before. On the next trial, the chief Hmong testify that they disagreed with the decision on building the road across the land of Hyeongjisa Temple. But the government has asked them to collect an admission fee in return for constructing the road, and so they have agreed. They thought fewer people would use the road if they asked them to pay. In cross-examining, Yoon-woo brings up Hyeongjisa Temple receiving a profit of 1 billion won a year because of the admission fee. The monk reasons that the money is used to maintain and repair the Hyeongjisa Temple property. Yoon-woo argues that the temple already receives government aid, so the admission fee is additional revenue. The chief monk points out that they have not broken the law in any way. Meanwhile, Ji-soo visits Myung-seok in the hospital, and lashes out at him for staying in Jeju, instead of going back to Seoul to get his surgery done. Myung-seok explains to her that the appointment for the surgery isn't until later, so there is no point in going back to Seoul. Yoon-woo walks in complaining that they would most probably lose the trial, since they can't seem to find a dent in any of the defendant's claims. Ji-soo interrupts them, so Yoon-woo and Ji-soo graze each other. On seeing Myung-seok gets lively while talking to Yoon-woo, Ji-soo leaves the room. As Yoon-woo leaves Myung-seok's room, she runs into Ji-soo, who is waiting outside the room. Ji-soo hurriedly admits that the reason she left Myung-seok is because she felt lonely when she is with Myung-seok, because he was more focused on work. Yoon-woo gets a call from Gwang-ho to check on her. As they talk, Yoon-woo tells him that Joon-ho is a person who can make her happy and would take care of her as Gwang-ho does. She tearfully wonders if she could do the same for Joon-ho. The next day, Yoon-woo and Joon-ho again go to watch Dolphins. To Joon-ho's shock, Yoon-woo suggests that they should break up. While Joon-ho takes in what Yoon-woo just told him, and tries to figure out the reason, Yoon-woo realizes that the road across Hyeongjisa's property is ultimately a public property. She goes on about her argument to Joon-ho's disappointment, and decides to meet with Myung-seok. Joon-ho lashes out at her for suddenly deciding to break up without giving him an explanation. Yoon-woo just apologizes to him and leaves. On the next trial day, Yoon-woo explains her argument about the road being a public property, despite it passing through Hyeongjisa Temple's land. After the trial, Yoon-woo decides to ride back to the apartment with Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik. To their shock, Yoon-woo tells them that she decided to break up with Joon-ho. Min-woo and Soo-yeon also realize that Joon-ho fought with Yoon-woo. So Min-woo suggests that they should go out for a drink. As they drink up, Min-woo and Soo-yeon assume that Yoon-woo felt pressured because Joon-ho suddenly took her to see his sister. They assume that is the reason Yoon-woo wanted to break up. Min-woo notices a bug in Soo-yeon's glass, so he gets a new glass for her. Meanwhile, Geu-ra-mi and Min-sik take Yoon-woo to a karaoke club to sing breakup songs. When Joon-ho and the others return to their apartment, Soo-yeon decides to talk with Min-woo. She lashes out for his sudden change in personality, bringing up all the good deeds he did during their stay in Jeju, and demands to know what he is trying to pull up. Min-woo wonders why she is keeping track of his behavior, and asks her jokingly if she has feelings for him. To his surprise, Soo-yeon does not deny it and starts to hiccup. Geu-ra-mi, Min-seok, and Yeon-woo see Min-woo and Soo-yeon staring at each other on returning from the karaoke club. Geu-ra-mi notices the tension between the two, and gets upset since she got rejected by Min-woo, even before she could confess to him. She decides to go back to the karaoke club to sing more songs. Min-seok is also saddened to see Soo-yeon with Min-woo, so joins Geu-ra-mi, and Yeon-woo too ends up following them. The next day, Joon-ho helps Myung-seok with his discharge. Myung-seok tells him about his wanting to get back with Ji-soo, but can't seem to say the right things to her. He advises Joon-ho to hold on to the person he likes unlike him. On their way back to Seoul, the team notices the ticket booth has closed up. They go to meet the chief monk. Myung-seok apologizes to the monk for the trial. He advises the monk to discuss with their administration to get more organizational funds for Hyun-jisa Temple, now that their main source of income has been cut off. Myung-seok also offers to help them get the government's attention on the matter. Delighted by his offer, the monk invites them to have lunch with them. They get served noodles for lunch. Myung-seok remarks that the noodles taste just like the ones in Hanbuk noodles. Yeon-woo realizes that the Hanbuk noodles owner is in the temple. The team rushes to see him in the kitchen, and introduces themselves explaining to him that they searched for him to get a bowl of noodles made for Myung-seok. Yeon-woo and her team offer to help him regain his business, since Hangun has broken many laws related to trademarks. So the Hanbuk noodles owner happily agrees to use the law to get back his business. He then cooks noodles for them, and Yeon-woo happily watches as Myung-seok enjoys it. Back in Hinbada, Seon-young watches the news of Soo-mi's confirmation hearing for the Ministry of Justice will be in 1 month's time. She meets with reporter Joon-bom. She confirms Joon-bom's suspicion of Yeon-woo being Soo-mi's daughter. Seon-young agrees to share all the evidence he needs about Yeon-woo and Soo-mi, under the condition that the article should be published right before Soo-mi's confirmation hearing, so she won't be able to refute it. Joon-bom eagerly agrees to it. With that, the episode ends. Thank you so much for joining in. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.